Welcome to a brand new coaster review. Today we're looking at my personal favorite coaster at Busch Gardens Tampa. This is Kumba. It's an old school B&M, and man, is this a great ride, guys. I was a little worried going in because I had heard some stories of people saying it was rough, but I know everyone had said it was intense. When I went through this ride, I got 5 rides in on it, including some night rides. Guys, I thought it was smooth. I thought it was really intense, and sometimes it feels hard to find a coaster like this nowadays. I love these old school B&Ms. They just don't make them like they used to. And man, does this thing roar. This is a loud ride. It's a B&M sit-down coaster, but it looks like it'd be a ride that's a floorless. Interestingly enough, though, it does have a floor, but I don't think that takes away from the ride at all. This ride powers you through 7 inversions, over 140 feet tall, and this is one of those few coasters that actually has a loop through the lift hill. But that vertical loop is only one of the inversions. There's also a 0G roll, a couple of corkscrews, that's where that famous shot is taken. There's also a Cobra roll, which normally I'm not huge on Cobra rolls, but I gotta say, that is probably one of the smoothest Cobra rolls I have ever been through. So I had absolutely no problem with that element. In addition, there's also a dive loop, and what I really like about this coaster is how everything is nonstop back to back. If I had to compare it to another ride, I know this is kind of an odd one to compare it to, but I would almost compare it to Riddler's Revenge. Obviously, that is a stand-up coaster, but you feel a lot of similar forces between those two rides. But you can also find a lot of other B&M coasters that have even similar layouts to Kumba. You look at Bizarro or Scream, those aren't too far off. It's almost like B&M had this recipe for making these coasters that had slightly different layouts but featured the same elements. And for whatever reason, Kumba, I thought, executed that layout above average. This ride makes my top 25. And that's pretty hard to do, considering at this moment when I'm recording this video, I've ridden 430 roller coasters. I honestly, going in, didn't expect to like Kumba as much as I did. I'd heard some people say it was the best, I'd heard some people say that it wasn't as good as some of the others. So that's kind of interesting. But I mean, when you look at it, a lot of the rides that are really well done, or just get rave reviews, you're also going to find people that don't think it's as good as what everyone says. So in that regard, the fact that Kumba, I had heard some mixed reviews, I think could be a good thing. Some will really like it, some may not enjoy it as much as others. If you like a good, intense ride, you're gonna enjoy this. It's a powerhouse, it really is. Now, regarding which seat you should sit in, I got to do this coaster in the front and the back and some spots in the middle. I think I ended up riding back more than front. Back, I thought, was more intense. I mean, it's really smooth in pretty much whatever seat you get in. But if you don't know how to ride a B&M, sometimes you just gotta keep your head forward. Like, even though you probably won't get head banging on this, just to eliminate the possibility, it's good to keep your head forward above the restraint. And if you're smaller, where your ears are still like right up against the over-the-shoulder harness, then you might not enjoy it as much as someone who, say, is a bit taller and doesn't have to deal with that. Now, if there is a downside to this coaster, it's that there isn't really a whole lot of theming to it. It's like, oh, look, palm trees, forest. And then in the end, there is this helix that kind of goes around through a tunnel. So that's kind of cool, I guess, but I don't know if I'd consider that theming. Now, it doesn't really bother me that this ride doesn't have theming. It's just kind of a generic theme. It's a ride that looks good. It's got beautiful colors. As you can see, this footage was taken as it was starting to get dark, so I'm really not capturing the true vibrancy of this color scheme. But it's just as fun to watch as it is to ride. So for Kumba's final score, I'll be giving it a perfect 10. Now, obviously, I don't give out 10s too often, so why am I giving out a 10 here? That's because I'm not looking at this and comparing it to every single ride I've ever ridden. I'm actually comparing this to other B&M coasters. And when you do that, I would consider this ride better than most. Is it the best B&M? I don't think so. But you don't have to be the best to be given a 10. The way I look at it is I think, okay, a 10 would be that they couldn't have done that type of ride better than they did. And I think B&M did the best that they could, and it was very well executed. And like I said earlier, the fact that there isn't really any theming doesn't bother me. All in all, if you're going to Busch Gardens Tampa, this is a ride that you won't want to miss. It's not going to be for everyone. Depending on what type of ride you're into, you may like it more or less than you expect, but it is definitely one of those coasters that you should have on your bucket list. So that's going to do it for this review of Kumba at Busch Gardens Tampa. Let me know what you think of this ride down in the comment section below, and of course, stay tuned for more coaster reviews here at Coaster Studios.